Ordering and sorting seem to be the same thing, right? Well, not if you're using Hibernate. Then these are two different approaches that produce the same result. So what's the difference and which one should you use? Hi, I'm Torben Jansen and I solve Java persistence problems for a living. In this video, I will answer the questions and show you which approach is the best for your application and when you shouldn't use neither of them. But before we start, if you're new here and you want to learn how to create your entity mappings with ease, build incredible efficient persistence layers with Hibernate and Spring, and all types of other Java persistence related stuff, subscribe now and click the bell to get new videos every week. And also don't forget to like this video if you found it helpful. By doing so, you are helping me to reach more people with it. Okay, first of all, I'm sorry about the distinction between ordering and sorting. My English teacher would probably be mad at me if she would hear this. But I didn't come up with the names. That's how the features are called in Hibernate. And yes, there are two different features. Both allow you to define the order of the elements in a too-many association. But they use different approaches, and you should be familiar with the difference if performance is important for your application. Sorting and ordering seem to do the same. They bring the associated entities into a defined order, but they differ in the approach. When you use sorting, Hibernate will load the associated book entities from the database and use the Java comparator to sort them in memory. That is not a good approach for huge sets of entities. Ordering uses an order by clause in the SQL statement to retrieve the entities in the defined order. Databases handle these kinds of operations very efficiently, so this approach is a lot better for huge associations. Two quick notes before we look at the two options in more detail. Hibernate applies sorting and ordering every time it retrieves the associated entities. You should be sure that you always need the associated entities in the defined order. Otherwise, ordering and sorting are just an unnecessary overhead that slows down your application. Sorting is a proprietary Hibernate feature. If you're using a different JPA implementation, you should skip the sorting part and go directly to the ordering section of this video. Okay, let's start with sorting. In all examples in this video, I will use an author entity with a many-to-many association to a book entity. The association mapping differs for both approaches. So please pay close attention to the type and the mapping annotations of the book's attribute. As you can see in the code, I use a sorted set as the type of the attributes that map the relationship. Sorting requires you to either use a sorted set or a sorted map as an attribute type. For both of them, all elements have to implement comparable and stores them in a defined order. In this example, the implementation of the compare method of the book entity is pretty simple. It uses the compareTo method of the string class to sort them in the alphabetically order by its title. You can choose between two approaches to sort the elements of your association. You can either use natural sorting or you can provide a custom comparator. You can tell Hibernate to use natural sorting by annotating the association attribute with sortNatural. This approach uses the comparable implementation of the related entities. Let's load an author entity with its three associated book entities from the database and see what happens. The query in the code snippet uses a join fetch clause to retrieve the author entity together with all associated book entities. This is a common best practice to efficiently initialize associations. As you can see in the log output, Hibernate executes the query without an order by clause. It then uses the compare method of the book entity to sort the three book entities alphabetically and stores them in the sorted set. When you don't want to use the comparable implementation of your entities for sorting, you can use the sort comparator annotation to provide a custom comparator. As you might guess from its name, the comparator in this example uses the ID attribute to compare the book entities. When you now execute the same test case as in the previous example, Hibernate uses the sort by ID comparator instead of the compare method of the book entity. And you can see in the log output that the book's attribute now contains the associated book entities in the order of their ID attributes. That's all about sorting for now. As you've seen, sorting doesn't have any effect on the database query. It happens after Hibernate retrieved the associated entities. You can either use the compareTo method implementation of the associated entity class, or a custom comparator to sort the entities. Now let's take a look at ordering. The ordering feature is defined by the JPA specification and does what most developers expect. It uses an order by clause in the SQL query to retrieve the associated entities in a specific order. In contrast to the sorting feature, you can use ordering on lists and your entities don't have to implement the comparable interface. You shouldn't use it with sorted sets to avoid an additional sorting of the already ordered entities. You can define the order by clause with JPA's order by annotation. If you don't provide any additional information, Hibernate will order the associated entities by their primary key. If you want to retrieve them in a different order, you can define an order by list in the same way as you would do in your JPQL query. So when you want to retrieve the associated book entities in alphabetical order of their title, you just need to provide title ask to the order by annotation on the book's attribute. When you now use the same test case as in the previous examples to load an author entity with all related book entities, you can see that Hibernate added an order by clause to the SQL statement. So this time the database returns the records in the defined order and Hibernate just needs to map them to book entities. After watching this video, I hope it became obvious that you should order your entities and not sort them. The two main reasons are performance and portability. The ordering of result set records is a typical task for relational databases. They are highly optimized for it and you can easily benefit from that by annotating your entity association with an order by annotation. The ordering feature is defined by the JPA specification, so you can use it with every compliant JPA implementation like Hibernate, EclipseLink or OpenJPA. Okay, let's summarize this video. When you want to retrieve associated entities in a specific order, Hibernate can sort or order them. Sorting happens within your Java application using a comparable or comparator implementation. Ordering adds an order by clause to the database query so that the database performs the task. That is the preferable approach because databases are highly optimized for these kinds of operations and handle them more efficiently than your Java code. But before you introduce ordering to your application, please keep in mind that Hibernate will order the associated entities every time it retrieves them from the database. So better make sure that you always need the entities in the given order. Otherwise, you add unnecessary overhead to your application, which slows down the performance. Okay, that's it for today. If you want to learn more about Hibernate, you should join the free member library. It gives you free access to a lot of member-only content, like a cheat sheet for this video, and an ebook about using native queries with JPA and Hibernate. I'll add the link to it to the video description below. And if you liked today's video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe below. Bye!